I have this interesting little box here that I want to show you. What is in the box? Well, that's to be found out here. It's not a jewelry box. It is actually a travel alarm clock. Yeah, I can't really see that too well. Let me see, try to zoom in on it here. There we go. That kind of shows it. It's got a very kind of reflective face on the dial, so it's hard to really get a good shot of it, but it is an Elka brand travel alarm clock. It's a Keywound travel, a Keywound clock, which means you have to wind it up. It doesn't have batteries. You don't plug it in, so it works completely on its own, but if you forget to wind it, it stops, which could be a bit of a pain in the ass if you're relying on it to get you up in the morning. This was an eBay purchase many years ago, and it was brand new in the box when I bought it. I no longer have the box because back then I didn't think about keeping the box with it. So I unfortunately threw the box away, which would have been nice to have, although I don't remember the box actually saying much on it. I looked up Elka to see, since that's the brand on it, I looked up Elka to find out some history, and I found, the only thing I could find was there is currently an Elka watch company. I don't remember what country they were from, but, they didn't turn up until sometime in the, 2000s, 2010s, something like that, they started. And then prior to them, starting back toward the early part of the last century, around the 19-teens, there was another Elka watch company that is no affiliation with the newer one, and they lasted until, I think it said around the year 2000. So I'm thinking this may be somehow connected to that company, but I think they were in Denmark or someplace like that. Excuse me. But anyways, this I'm guessing is like 1960s or 1970s vintage. It is a seven jewel movement, if you know what that means. Watchmakers and clockmakers back in the day when things were key wound, as this one is, used jewels to reduce friction on the moving parts. It's literally what they use are things like industrial rubies, which aren't worth a ton of money, you know, as you know, ruby is a precious stone, but it they're cut in such a way that the things that pivot back and forth can ride on them with very little friction. And so it's seven jewels, and it is a German-made movement. It's right down below that green dot below the six. It says Germany, but I don't think we're going to be able to see it unless maybe I can. I need to see if I can get in here close without a glare. You can just kind of see it there, maybe. But yeah, it's a decent little clock. Let me show you how it works. On the back is the controls. You've got this knob up here, which sets the alarm time. This knob here sets the regular time. This little knob over here pulls out. you pull it out to turn the alarm on, and when the alarm goes off and you want it to shut up, you push that button back in and it shuts the alarm off. And then this here is obviously the key for winding it, which I just wound it, so it's tight, so I can't wind it anymore. But yeah, those are the controls. So if I, for instance, you can look at the front, you can see that the alarm hand is that kind of brass colored one right by the 9. If I turn it, I can set the alarm wherever I want. So like you can't, it's not like a digital clock where you can set it to actual 6:30, but if you want to get up at 6:30, you set it basically between the 6 and the 7. And you'll wake up roughly around 6:30. All right. And so let me actually, what I'll do now is I'll pull the thing out so that we can hear the alarm go off. And I'm going to turn the alarm until it gets around to the current time. And it should go off. And that's the alarm. It's not super loud, but it works. And it'll get you up in the morning. And then, since it's a travel alarm clock, it folds up into this little thing so you can pack it in your suitcase. It's still running. When you open it up, I don't know if you can hear it ticking. But yeah. Like I say, I've had this for probably 15 to 20 years or more. And I've used it. I've taken it to Florida with me a few times and actually used it as a travel alarm clock. I've used it at times when my regular alarm clock is kind of bit the big one. And it works. It works well. It keeps good time as long as you keep it well wound. It tends to run fast if the winding of it, if it gets down, you know, real to the point of almost running out, it starts running faster for some reason. You would think it would run slower, but this one gains when it gets lower. But yeah, it's kind of a cool thing. I wish I had a little bit more information on the company that made it, but I couldn't find much. And I looked on eBay and there are no Elka travel alarm clocks on eBay. There was a whole bunch of them back when I bought it, but not anymore. I guess they sold them all. So this is my Elka 7 jewel Keywound travel alarm clock. Probably vintage 1960s, early 1970s. Before quartz movements came around and made these key wound ones kind of obsolete. But it's a good running clock and it's kind of pretty. So thanks for watching and take care. We'll see you in the next video. Bye now.